Shipbuilders are testing to see if laser scanning technology will work aboard ships at sea. They hope successful laser scanning aboard the tugboat Huntington will lead to projects aboard larger ships like the USS John C. Stennis, CVN 74, a nuclear-powered supercarrier in the Navy. We tagged along to check out the tests.
Laser scanning basically is a picture, but with dimensional data. It's like you're walking on the ship on your computer screen.
That's Woody Woods. He and Nathan Vandegrift are testing laser scanning technology along the James River.
So today we're on the tug to see down in the engine room that vibration testing, because usually when we scan, we're tied up to a pier, the engines aren't running, and we're tied up and sitting still. So today we're trying to get as much movement and vibration to see how it affects the scanner.
Vibration can impact your dimensional data, and the last thing we want is to spend a lot of money going to CVN 74 and find out the data is useless. So we're hoping that this test shows that the scan data while operating at sea is useful data.
The shipbuilders are also introducing a new laser scanning tool during their test.
The hand scanner that we have, that's for spaces where we can't take the big FARO scanner we have. So things that are smaller, we usually use the hand scanner for pipe to get around. If we need something quick, that's a really quick way to get a scan, or the other one takes a little bit of time.
After review, the team found out that vibrations don't distort laser scan images. Woods says laser scanning at sea will help speed up ship checks and speed up contracts. This investment in technology will shape and create opportunities for business growth. For Newport News Shipbuilding, I'm Lena Wallace.